Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to talk about basics of performance testing. So the agenda will be, we'll discuss what is performance testing and why do we need performance testing and what are the types of performance testing and then what are the common performance problems we will discuss and then performance testing process. And after that, we'll discuss performance testing metrics. And then we'll see a few examples of performance test cases and then performance testing tools. Now let's get started. So first one is, what is performance testing? So a performance testing is defined as a type of software testing comes under basically non-functional and which will ensure software applications will perform well under expected workload. So features and functionality supported by a software system is not the only concern. A software application's performance, like its response time, reliability, resource usages, and scalability also matters. So the goal of performance testing is not to find bugs, but to eliminate the performance bottlenecks. So the main focus of the performance testing is we have to check speed, scalability, and stability of the software program. So speed basically determines whether the application responds quickly, and scalability determines maximum user load the software application can handle, and stability determines if the application is stable under varying loads. So basically the performance testing is also called as a perf testing. So the next one is, why do we need to performance testing? Why do we need performance? Why do we perform the performance testing? So performance testing is done to provide stakeholders with information about their application regarding speed, stability, and scalability. So more importantly, performance testing uncovers what needs to be improved before the product goes to market. So without performance testing, software is likely to suffer from issues such as running slow while several users use it simultaneously, sometimes inconsistencies across different operating systems, and poor usability. So performance testing will determine whether their software meets a speed, scalability, and stability requirements under expected workloads. So applications sent to market with poor performance metrics due to non-existence or poor performance testing are likely to gain a bad reputation and fail to meet expected sales goals. So hence, we need to perform the performance testing, and this is most important for us. And next one, what are the different types of performance testing we have to conduct? So basically we have a load testing, stress testing, endurance testing, spike testing, and then volume testing. Now let us discuss what are these types of testings. So the first one is a load testing. So load testing checks the application's ability to perform under anticipated user loads. So the objective is to identify performance bottlenecks before the software application goes live. The next one is stress testing. So stress testing involves testing an application under extreme workloads to see how it handles high traffic or data processing. So the objective is to identify the breaking point of an application. So the next one is endurance testing. So endurance testing is done to make sure the software can handle the expected load over a long period of time. And the next one is spikes testing. So spike testing tests the software's reaction to sudden large spikes in the load generated by the users. And the last one is volume testing. So under volume testing, large number of data is populated in the database and the overall software system's behavior is monitored. So the objective is to check the software application's performance under varying database volumes. So these are the different types of performance testings. So now we will see what are the common performance problems. So most of the performance problems revolve around speed, response time, load time, and poor scalability. So speed is often one of the most important attributes of an application. So a slow running application will lose potential user. So performance testing is done to make sure an app runs faster enough to keep a user's attention and interest. So let us look at a few performance problems I have listed out here. So the first one is long load time, poor response time, poor scalability, and then bottlenecking. So long load time. So long time is normally the initial time it takes the application to start. So it should generally be kept to a minimum. So while some applications are impossible to make a load in under a minute, so load time should be kept under a few seconds if possible. So the next one is poor response time. So response time is the time it takes from when a user inputs data into the application until the application output a response to that input. So generally this should be very quick. And again, if a user has to wait too long, they lose interest. The next one is poor scalability. So a software product suffers from poor scalability when it cannot handle the expected number of users or when it does not accommodate a wide enough range of users. So load testing should be done to be certain the application can handle the anticipated number of users. The next one is a bottleneck. So a bottlenecks are abstractions in a system which degrade overall system performance. So bottlenecking is when either coding errors or hardware issues cause a decrease of throughput under certain loads. So bottlenecking is often caused by one faulty section of a code. So the key to fixing a bottlenecking issue is to find the section of the code that is causing the slowdown and try to fix it there. So bottlenecking is generally fixed by either fixing poor running processes or adding additional hardware. So here we'll see some common performance bottlenecks like CPU utilization, memory utilization, network utilization, operating system limitations, and then disk usage. So these are the some common performance bottlenecks. Now let's discuss about performance testing process. So the methodology adapted for performance testing can vary widely, but the objective for performance test remains the same. So it can help demonstrate that your software system meets certain predefined performance criteria, or it can help compare the performance of two systems, two software systems. So it can also help identify parts of your software system which degrade its performance. So here a generic process on how to perform a performance testing. So this is a common generic process. So let us discuss every item in this particular process. So first one is identify the test environment. So first of all, we need to know your physical test environment, production environment, and what testing tools are available. So understand details of the hardware, software, and network configurations used during testing before you begin the testing process. So it will help testers create more efficient tests. It will also help identify possible challenges that testers may encounter during the performance testing procedures. So the next one is plan and design the performance test. So determine how usage is likely to vary amongst end users and identify key scenarios to test for all possible use cases. It is necessary to simulate a variety of end users. Plan performance test data and outline what metrics will be gathered. So the next one is identify performance acceptance criteria. So basically this includes goals and constraints for throughput, response times, and resource allocation. It is also necessary to identify project success criteria outside of these goals and constraints. So testers should be empowered to set performance criteria and goals, because often the project specifications will not include a wide enough variety of performance benchmarks. So sometimes there may be none at all. So when possible, finding a similar application to compare to is a good way to set performance goal. So the next one is configure test environment. So we need to prepare the testing environment before execution. So also arrange tools and other resources. So the next one is implement test design. So it creates the first of all, you need to create the performance test according to your test design. So again, test design will be created based upon the performance requirements. And then execute test. So here we need to execute a performance test cases, and then we'll need to monitor the test. And finally, analyze and report. And here we need to analyze and share the test results. Then fine tune and test again to see if there are any improvement or decrease in performance. So since improvements generally grow smaller with each retest, because we need to do sometimes retesting and tuning, analyzing here. And since improvements generally grow smaller with each retest, so stop when bottlenecking is caused by the CPU. So then you may have the considered option of increasing CPU power. So this is all about the performance testing process. The next one is performance testing metrics. So these are the common parameters which you need to monitor after conducting the performance testing. So I will discuss a few important parameters listed out here. The first one is a processor usage, which is an amount of time a processor spends executing non-ideal threads. The next one is memory use. It is an amount of physical memory available to processes on a computer. The next one is disk time. So it is an amount of time disk is busy executing a read or write request. And then bandwidth. It shows the bits per second used by a network interface. And next one, private bytes. It is a number of bytes a process has allocated that can't be shared amongst other processes. So these are used to measure memory leaks and usages. So the next one is committed memory. So it is a basically amount of virtual memory used. The next important metric is response time and throughput. So response time is a time from when a user enters a request until the first character of the response is received. The next important parameter is throughput. Is the rate a computer or network receives a request per a second. And amount of connection pooling. So the number of user requests that are met by pooled connections. So the more requests met by connections in the pool, the better the performance will be. The next one is maximum active sessions. So the maximum number of sessions that can be active at once we need to measure. The next one is hit ratios. So this has to do with the number of SQL statements that are handled by catch data instead of expensive IO operations. So this is a good place to start for solving bottlenecking issues. And the next one is hits per second. So it is basically the number of hits on web server during each second of a load test. And finally, thread counts. So it is an application's health can be measured by number of threads that are running and currently active. So these are the common parameters which we need to monitor when you're doing performance testing. So the next one is, we'll see some common examples of some performance test cases. So here the first test case is verify response time is not more than 4 seconds when 1,000 users access the website simultaneously. And the other test case is verify response time of the application under load is within an acceptable range when the network connectivity is slow. So the next test case is check the maximum number of users that the application can handle before it crashes. So basically here we do stress testing and check database execution time when 500 records are read, write simultaneously. So this comes under endurance testing and check CPU and memory usage of the application and the database server under peak load conditions. This is again comes under the load testing. And finally, verify response time of the application under low, normal, moderate, and heavy load conditions. So this is basically comes under the spike testing. So these are all different test cases which are comes under the different categories of load, different categories of performance testing like load testing, stress testing, endurance testing, spike testing. So finally, we will see what are the performance tools are available in the market. So JMeter and Micro Focus Loadrunner becomes very popular tools currently in the market in the nowadays. And there are other performance tools also available like Neon Load and Load Ninja. So these are all different performance testing tools which are currently available in the market to perform the load testing and trust testing and other types of testing on web-based applications and also servers. So these are all different types of performance testing tools. Now the conclusion is, in software engineering, performance testing is necessary before marketing any software product. So it ensures customer satisfaction and protects an investor's investment against product failure. So costs of performance testings are usually more than made up for with improved customer satisfaction, loyalty, and retention. So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.